الله أكبر، 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 الله أكبر كبيرا، والحمد لله كثيرا، وسبحان الله وبحمده بكرة وأصيلا. اللهم صل وسلم وبارك على سيدنا محمد، اللهم أحينا على سنته وأمتنا على ملته، واحشرنا في زمرته وتحت لوائه، واسقنا من حوضه الشريف شربة هنيئة مريئة لا نظمأ بعدها أبدا يا رب العالمين. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، شهادة المقر بربوبيته المعترف بألوهيته الموقن بأن لا حاكمية إلا له، شهادة إسلام وإيمان وإحسان. وأشهد أن سيدنا ونبينا وعظيمنا وإمامنا وحبيبنا محمد ابن عبد الله عبده ورسوله، أدى الأمانة وبلغ الرسالة ونصح الأمة وكشف الأمة وتركها على المحجة البيضاء ليلها كنهارها لا يزيغ ولا يضل عنها إلا هالك، صلى الله وسلم عليك يا سيدي يا رسول الله، صلى الله وسلم عليك يا علم الهدى ويا معلم الخير. All praise be to Allah. We praise Him, we thank Him, we seek His help, His forgiveness and His guidance. And we seek refuge in Allah from the evilness of our bad, of our souls and the adverse consequences of our bad deeds. I do testify that there is no deity worthy of worship except Allah alone, with no partners or associates, and that Muhammad ibn Abdullah is his last prophet and messenger. In this special day that is overflowing with blessings and mercy, we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to open our minds so we can understand, to open our hearts so we can love each other, and to give us the stamina so we can work for His cause. O Allah, we ask You by the virtue of the Eid not to leave upon us a sin but forgiven, not to leave among us an ailing person but healed, not to leave among us a depressed person but relieved, not to leave among us a needy person but satisfied, not to leave among us a lost person but return to his family safe and sound. O Allah, take us to Yourself as Muslims, give us lives as Muslims, and place us among those who are righteous, virtuous, and well-guided. Allahumma ameen. Today we celebrate, my respected brothers and sisters, a great accomplishment, a spiritual achievement that would enable us to carry on our lives and to fulfill our duties to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala after being empowered, prepared, and after being more qualified to deliver our duties. to enjoin good and forbid evil, to emanate compassion and to stand up for justice. We have been empowered and trained during this month of Ramadan to fulfill our duties as Muslims. We are in a better position to be decent people. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran, وَلِتُكْمِلُوا الْعِدَّةِ وَلِتُكَبِّرُوا اللَّهَ عَلَى مَا هَدَاكُمْ وَلَعَلَّكُمْ تَشْكُرُونَ. This is what we are celebrating. What Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran, so that you complete the prescribed period of time, the designated days, be it 29 or 30 days, and so that you glorify Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, so that you magnify Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for guiding you, ala ma hadakum. Alhamdulillah ala ni'mat al-Islam, alhamdulillah ala ni'mat al-Iman, alhamdulillah ala ni'mat shahri Ramadan. The bounty and the grace, by the grace of Allah, we have become Muslims. Umar bin al-Khattab, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala be pleased with him, when he was compared with Abu Bakr, somebody compared him with Abu Bakr al-Siddiq radiallahu anhu, he said, don't dare to compare me with Abu Bakr. Abu Bakr is in a much higher status. Who am I to be compared to Abu Bakr? By Allah, I remember the time when Abu Bakr was guided to Islam and he was much more pure than musk, while Umar bin al-Khattab was more misguided than the animal of his father. While Umar bin al-Khattab was misguided more the camel of al-Khattab. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and this is what we are celebrating, by His grace, by His mercy, He gave us this opportunity. وَإِنَّ رَبَّكَ لَذُو مَغْفِرَةٍ لِلنَّاسِ عَلَى ظُلْمِهِمْ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows that we oppress ourselves. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows that we wrong ourselves by committing all kinds of sins. In spite of that, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give us this opportunity of Ramadan. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in Ramadan would extend His maghfirah, His forgiveness, and His mercy. This is what we are celebrating. My dear brothers and sisters, we know of people, or we heard of people, who started Ramadan but did not get to finish it. We know of others who did not get the chance to witness Ramadan altogether. But you, alhamdulillah, we were given by the grace of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala the full opportunity to be exposed to the rahmah of Allah and the maghfirah of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is what we are celebrating. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the Quran says, وَإِذْ تَأَذَّنَ رَبُّكُمْ لَإِنْ شَكَرْتُمْ لَأَزِيدَنَّكُمْ. It is a promise that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has taken upon Himself. It is a covenant that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is giving us. It is an oath that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is making, that whenever you show thankfulness, whenever you show gratitude to Allah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will reciprocate that by showing you the gratitude in your life, by giving you tawfiq, by enabling you to be a winner when you meet with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَقَلِيلٌ مِّنْ عِبَادِيَ الشَّكُورِ. In spite of that, the people, the servants of Allah, who are really thankful to Allah, are very few. Very few. Now we need to ask us, Since we know this fact, are we truly thankful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? My dear brothers and sisters, one of the greatest lessons to be learned from the month of Ramadan, from this generous opportunity that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala extends for us, if not the greatest lesson at all, it is we have learned how to be thankful. We have learned how to appreciate the endless bounties of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We learn how to show thankfulness to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And we do that by being obedient to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in Surah Yunus says, قُلْ بِفَضْلِ اللَّهِ وَبِرَحْمَتِهِ فَبِذَلِكَ فَلْيَفْرَحُوا هُوَ خَيْرٌ مِمَّا يَجْمَعُونَ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala starts this ayah by saying, قُلْ, declare openly. And this is an order to Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And when somebody speaks to another person, there is a reason why they choose to speak. And that reason is to say something that the people do not know. And you can imagine Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has the highest example in this case. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is telling us, is informing us about something that we do not know, something that we misunderstood, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wanted us to get the record straight. قُلْ بِفَضْلِ اللَّهِ وَبِرَحْمَتِهِ فَبِذَلِكَ فَلْيَفْرَحُ هُوَ خَيْرٌ مِمَّا يَجْمَعُونَ. What is it that makes us joyful? What is it that makes us happy? What is it that makes us pleased? There are one thing and one thing only that is known to mankind, which is to compete against each other in accumulating the worldly gains, in being healthy and wealthy. And everybody is chasing that and competing to get the maximum share of that. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, no, this is not the right thing for you. There is something way more important, to the point that makes all your chase, all your pursuit for the gains, the worldly gains of the dunya, totally insignificant. You celebrate and you be joyful. You be happy that you have a merciful God. You be happy that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is merciful. You be happy that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is gracious. If Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is to treat you according to your deeds, even if you spend your whole life prostrating and making sujood for Allah, this will not equate one bounty that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has bestowed upon you. We make mistakes, we commit sins, and رحم الله من طال رب معصية أورثت ذلا وانكسارا خير من طاعة أورثت عزا واستكبارا. Not only that, some of the ulama went further and they said, even if you are happy with the good deeds that you have done, you shouldn't do that. You only be happy that you are the servant of Allah. You should be happy that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is gracious and merciful. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala take mercy on the one who said this. There is a sin, or the sin that causes you to be arrogant, the sin that causes you to have humility and modesty is better than the act of obedience if it will cause you to be arrogant, if it will cause you to have pride. Subhanallah, subhanallah. Yes, this is the situation that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loves. He loves the people who are humble to him and humble, respectful to the others. Who Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala does not like the people who have this false sense of superiority. Umar bin Khattab again, when he was dying, you know, the Sahaba came to console him and he said, rejoice, you are one of the 10 that have been given the glad tidings of Jannah. Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam died while he is pleased with you. You have established Islam in the corners of the world. And so on and so forth. Umar bin Khattab said, no, I do not lay any credit with that. It is only by the blessing of Allah that I was able to do this. In fact, وَذَدْتُ لَوْ أَنِّي خَرَجْتُ مِنْهَا كَفَافًا لَا لِي وَلَا عَلَيْهِ. I wish that I have come out of this dunya even, nothing for me and nothing against me. Imagine if Umar bin Khattab is saying this. How can we feel the pride of our good deeds? My dear brothers and sisters, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is looking for our gratitude, our appreciation. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wanted us to be thankful, and He doesn't need it. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala doesn't need us to thank Him. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is looking for that for our sake. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is looking for it so He can reciprocate it with gratitude of His own. The way we show thankfulness to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is being obedient to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It is to forbid evil and to enjoin good and to be compassionate and to stand up for justice. Brothers and sisters, while we are enjoying the celebration of Eid in peace and safely, you know, your other Muslim brothers and sisters do not have that luxury. In Syria, the Muslims there are being devastated. The number of killed, the people who are killed and injured is already in the tens of thousands. We should take a stand regarding that. The people of Burma, your brothers and sisters there are facing the Islamophobia and the hatred, and the number of people are killed, and it's still unfolding. Al-Aqsa is still under occupation. The Muslims who are worshipping and were absorbing Ramadan in the holy and blessed land were facing persecution from the Jewish settlers and the Israeli forces. Brothers and sisters, we need to show our thankfulness to Allah by doing something about this. If we can't support them, at least we keep them in our dua. We keep them and the other people who are facing the same throughout the world. For those who went to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in this blessed day of Ramadan, we ask that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala place them among the shuhada and the salihin. And for those who are injured or displaced, we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to ease their pain and sufferings. My dear brothers and sisters, this organization, Yasin Foundation, is a great achievement of this community. And it is a trust. You have to show your thankfulness to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Show your gratitude to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala by being involved in its activities. As it is like any other masjid, it helps establishing the deen of Allah in the area where it is organized. ربنا تقبل منا انك انت السميع العليم وتب علينا انك انت التواب الرحيم. الله اكبر الله اكبر الله اكبر لا اله الا الله الله اكبر الله اكبر ولله الحمد. عيدكم مبارك والسلام عليكم ورحمه الله وبركاته.
قامت بخير يا حاج.